Everybody, thank you for showing up. So we're brought here today to not just celebrate two people, but the union of two families. Alexandria, Adam, you two will forever be the brick and mortar that hold the two families together. Luckily, I know both of you individually and as a couple, and individually you're both wonderful, and together you're incredible. I have to call you Alexandria today instead of the usual Al or AC. And you've always been like a little sister to me, so this is a big day for everybody. You're a lucky man, Alex. Adam? Alex, you're a lucky man, so sorry. So, you ready to get this thing going? All right, let's do this. When we look at marriage, we can look to the Bible, and we can look at 1 Corinthians 4 through 7 to find the best examples. It explains that love is patient, love is kind, it does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud, it does not dishonor others. It's not self-seeking, it's not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrong. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, and always perseveres. I think you two have it. So, Adam, do you take Alex to be your wife? Do you promise to love and cherish in sickness and in health, in good times and bad, until death do you part, while forsaking all others? Alex, do you take Adam as your husband to love and cherish in sickness and in health, good times and bad, until death do you part, while forsaking all others? So, they've chosen to write their own vows today. And we're going to let Adam go ahead and start this. So, we'll take that. I vow to always be the man you need me to be, whether it be a strong man to get you through the toughest times, a sensitive man to hold you when you are sad or upset, a protecting man when you feel scared and alone. For everything you go through in life, I vow you will always have your man. I vow to keep you on your toes so that you never expect anything. And that is why. You're mine. Hold it, please. Thank you. I vow to be true to you. But most importantly, through every fight, every argument, and every tiny bicker, I vow will not change how I feel about you. I will love you each and every day, and you will always be my baby girl.
My sweet Adam, as I sit here writing these vows, I draw a blank. Not because I have nothing to say, but because the amount of love I have for you is immeasurable. Maybe it was your sweet smile, the way you were always there for me, that Jersey accent that you hate but I can't get enough of, or maybe it was the way your butt looked in football pants.
It was amazing.
I can't pinpoint exactly what first drew me in, but I'm so glad that it did. The past 6.5 years have been amazing. We've had our ups and downs, dealt with distance and heartache. But as I stand before you today, I'm so proud to say that we're stronger than ever. God has a plan for us all, and I'm honored that his plan has led us here today to celebrate our love in front of our family and friends. For the rest of our lives, we will be together as one. How amazing is that? So from this day forward, I promise to support you with all my heart. I promise to affirm you in public and in private. I promise to put you before anyone and anything else. I promise to rub your neck when you're stressed. I promise to motivate and challenge you to live up to the calling that you have received. I promise to ask you hard questions and hold you accountable. I promise to be faithful, to keep writing you love notes, and to commit to date night. I promise to be quick to forgive and try to be better with directions. I promise to respect and honor you. I promise to love you always. Our wedding is about far more than a day in a dress. It is about you and me becoming one by the powerful grace of God. From this day forward, I promise to always cherish every moment and live up to the calling of being your wife. I love you forever and always and after.
And for the exchanging of the rings, Adam, will you repeat after me? I give you this ring as a symbol of my love.
I give you this ring as a symbol of my love.
And as a constant reminder.
And as a constant reminder.
That I've chosen you above all others.
That I've chosen you above all others.
To be the one I share my life with.
Be the one I share my life with.
Repeat after me.
I give you this ring
as a symbol of my love
and as a constant reminder
that I've chosen you above all others to be the one to share my life with. So with no further ado, and if I may make the first announcement and congratulate you, Mr. and Mrs. Adam and Alexandria Vavrikin, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may now kiss the bride.
night, exchanging glances, wandering in the night. What were the chances we'd be sharing love before the night was through?
Starting with the parents, Lynn McLaughlin and Michael McLaughlin. Carolyn Vavrikan and Joseph Vavrikan. Bridesmaid Grace Young, accompanied by Anthony Vavrikan and Brandon Cassidy.
Beautiful, Grace.
The maid of honor, Emily Singleton, accompanied by the best man, John.
What the hell?
Go. And ladies and gentlemen, if you could please put your hands together for our bride and groom, Alexandria and Adam Vavrikan.
Something in your voice caused me to turn my head. Your smile just captured me. You were in my future, far as I could see. And I don't know how it happened, but it happened still. You asked me if I love you, if I always will. Well, you had me from hello. I felt love start to grow. The moment that I looked into your eyes, you want me. It was over from the start. You completely stole my heart. I won't let go. I never even had a chance to know. You had me from hello. Inside, I built a wall. So high around my heart, I thought I'd never fall. One touch, you brought it down. The bricks of my defenses scattered on the ground. And I swore to me I wasn't gonna love again. The last time was the last time I let someone in, but you had me from hello. And I felt love start to grow. The moment that I looked into your eyes, you want me. It was over from the start. You completely stole my heart. Now I won't let go. I never even had a chance, you know. You had me from hello. That's all you said. Something in your voice called me to turn my head. You had me from hello. Hello, girl, I love you.
Yeah.
Hello.
once again their first dance as a couple, Mr. and Mrs. Dougie.
Can I
with you one more time before I start down the road with my brand new life. There's no way to thank you for all that you have done. No matter how old I get, I will always be your son. And crashing in the sand. I probably scared you half to death. Hey mom, look, no hands. You were my best friend. You were my number one fan. Oh, every time that I got hurt, you were there to hold my hand. Oh, I may not call you as much as I should. I may not say I love you as much as I could. But you got to know this important thing is true. The person I've become and all I owe it all to you. I owe it all to you. All to you.
You watch me grow, and only you want what's best.
please put your hands together for Lynn McLaughlin, my finishing bride, and Randolph Abbott.
I like to be on this side, huh? There we go.
Is that
feeling or
something?
What?
Is that
feeling? Oh, yeah. Swing it around like that.
We're going to do the dollar dance, which is where you pay a nominal fee to the bride and the groom to have a few seconds to dance with.
I got 20.
So
I got 20 on that.
The bride and the groom, front and center, please.
You heard it.
Yeah, man. Bring it in. So it's probably got me wrong, I guess.
Yeah. Congressman Reed. Sorry. Oh, this is going to go great on Facebook. Oh, boy. Adam, you look lonely.
Let's go dance with Adam.
Won't you please arrange it? Come on,
there we go.
Wait, I start my own jar up?
The taco man.
Hey, look, you're taking a selfie.
No, it's his brother Ryan. He's at Fort Bliss.
Wait, let me get a picture with Ryan.
What's up?
No, it's Fort Bliss.
Grace, you want to dance with that? Oh, girl. Oh, yeah.
Cause I'm gonna give it to you. Cause that's a fuck, I'm gonna give it to you. Cause I'm gonna give it to you.
suppose I'd come at home. I suppose I would.
She backed my truck into, but she covered her mouth and her face got red, and she just looked so darn cute that I couldn't even act like I was mad. Yeah, I live for little moments like that. That's like just last year on my birthday. She lost all track of time and burnt the cake. And every smoke detector in the house was going off. And she was just about to cry until I took her in my arms.